The Cottonwood Public Library staff would like to present round two.
Round two.
By Terrence W. Walsh. The public library has their book back. It's 12 years overdue. The time is huge, and the borrower hasn't read it. Judge Byrne presides over 10 of our labs and snappy dialogue for the county of Over and Undershot.
The court of the county of Over and Undershot is now in session. The Honorable Judge Leroy Byrne presiding. All rise.
Good morning, Officer Munchkin.
That is Munchkin.
Who's Munchkin?
I am, Your Honor.
Are you not the bailiff?
Yep.
And is there not a rule against eating in this courtroom?
My name, sir, is Munchkin.
Then why are you
strapped?
Of course it is.
Good morning, Judge Byrne, alternate deputy assistant district attorney Lunch. And here is the complainant, is Ms. Hermione Booker from the original public library of Newer North Upper Undershot.
ADA Lunch, welcome to the court. This is your first appearance here?
Yes, Your Honor.
Officer Munching, have the clerk revise the rules to allow munching and lunch in the courtroom.
Yeah, I will.
Thank you, Your Honor.
And the defense?
Good morning, Judge Byrne. Attorney Morrow of Morrow & Morrow registers appearance for Mr. Charlie Crank, who is present.
So there are no tomorrows today?
And tomorrow should be enough for today, in this case, Your Honor.
Very well. Mr. Lunch, do you wish to make an opening statement?
Your Honor, 12 years ago, Mr. Plank borrowed a book from the public library at Newer North Upper Undershot. He never returned it. The library sent the usual notices, no results. According to the loan agreement, the library will bill the full cost of the book after 3 notices. If not paid promptly, then interest accrues at 5% compounded monthly. The total now due is $14,572.32. Plus $100 in costs and fees. And of course, most importantly, return the book.
What was the cost of the book?
Carrie.
It was $12.95.
That's quite a stretch from $12.95 to $14,572.32.
Yes, Your Honor. It's the magic of compound interest at work. 12 years.
There's no free lunch. Ms. Morrow, what have you to say?
Not guilty. The fine is outrageous. There's no evidence of a contract.
I see. ADA Lunch, have you witnesses?
The people call Ms. Hermione Booker.
Hermione Booker, raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, et cetera?
I do, et cetera.
You do.
It's lunchtime. Proceed. Ms. Booker, by whom are you employed?
I'm employed by the original public library of Newer North Upper Undershot.
But this complaint is from the public library, not the original public library. Why?
Same thing. 12 years ago, it was the public library. 10 years ago, the library burned down. All the books burned. So when we rebuilt and we reopened, we became the original public library to welcome our readers home to a new building they had never library of Old North Upper Undershot or to South Undershot. Some stopped reading entirely. A few even went so far as Lower Overshot.
The library burned down, and how could Mr. Plank return the book?
The several agreements of the Greater Shot Group Metro Library System. He could return it anywhere.
Even to Lower Undershot?
Yes. After the fire, our only surviving original books were those out on loan. They became valuable, very valuable, like eBay gold. We sold some to pay for the building of the new library.
It's so sad to see him go.
So you really want to collect $14,572.32?
Yes.
Plus $100 in costs and fees?
Yes, and get the book back.
No more questions.
Miss Booker, did anyone call Mr. Plank? Talk to him?
Oh, yes, we called. I called. Mr. Plank promised to return it after lunch the next day, but tomorrow never came.
May it please the court, tomorrow and Morrow had no client then.
What's that?
Mr. Plank hired Morrow and Morrow for today, just yesterday.
What about back then?
Our firm formed freshly from Frank Shingles last year. And 12 years ago, there were no two Morrows in law.
12 years ago, there were no tomorrows. That's when I became a judge.
Ms. Booker, does the library have a record of Mr. Plank's alleged loan agreement that creates this outrageous fine?
Objection! The fine is not outrageous.
Sustained. The fine might be outrageous. It seems outrageous. But outrageousness has not been established. Let's try again, Miss Morrow.
Miss Booker, does the library have a record of Mr. Plank's alleged loan agreement that created this fine?
No. Mr. Plank's loan agreement was destroyed in the fire.
No more questions.
The people rest.
Any defense?
Moves for dismissal, Your Honor. Lack of evidence.
How's that?
There's no evidence of a contract, and the amount is outrageous. $14,572.32 plus $100 in costs and fees for a $12.95 book.
Well, Mr. ADD Lunch?
It's a matter of case law. Public Library of Farther East Overshot versus Helga T. Jensen. The library burned down, the records were destroyed, but they still collected the overdue fine.
An awful lot of book burning here going on here. How much did they get?
The book was worth $12.95. $41.77 plus return of the book, of course.
And the outrageous amount?
It's just mathematical magic. Compound interest.
Ms. Marlowe, your motion to dismiss is dismissed. It's a matter of case law plus the magic of compound interest. If you have witnesses, let's proceed. Today, Ms. Marlowe.
Mr. Plank, what happened?
I just couldn't return it unfinished.